Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty. Our cast number 121, I'm pretty sure. Or no, 122 actually, I think. And yeah, so this one's going to go up Friday, and I'm going to put a kind of a time limit on this one. So that it actually gets up, because it's like already 1 o'clock in the afternoon. But I thought, well, shoot, if I get a video out today. Sorry, I was reaching over there to get a rag to paint with. Then I actually got my 5 videos up this week, which is kind of cool. I don't remember the last time I actually got 5 up in a week, so. But we did the... This is like the first show I'm recording after that monster Artcasters chat show I did. Oh, what's a good angle today? It's just kind of shining on it. The piece is real loose right now. It's like my first kind of pass. Obviously doing something based on Medusa. And I got this guy in here, which he's kind of roughed in like an underpainting, but it's not near what I did on the last one. And I'm kind of just going in more with color and doing it my usual way, I guess. Well, every time I start one of these, it seems like I start it different, so I'm doing that again. I'm starting this one different. But anyway, now I'm like way over from my palette and stuff. Set this up so I can get to it easier. Hang on a second. Alright, I'm a little closer now. Got my palette sitting down on a chair next to me. But, anyway, yeah, this is the first show I've done since that huge, gigantic art cast, that was, I guess, Wednesday. And, like yesterday's show, I actually had recorded before I had uploaded it for that day that we did that art cast, so I just left it uploaded. That's why the pieces are kind of a little bit, you know, like one day I'll be painting it and the next day I'll actually be drawing it. I know they're kind of wonky, but just been kind of a weird week with everything that's going on. Doing shows with Mike kind of throws it off, and then also like the Artcaster show threw my schedule off a little bit too. In a good way though. That was a lot of fun. I don't know if anybody's watched it. It's like a monster show though. I just went and looked. It's like almost 6 hours, just shy. Like 5 hours 58 seconds or something like that. Which is, yeah. That's a big show. So that's the new record, 6 hours. I was tired even. I was even like running out of gas. I think that the last two people that were in there with me were like Lisa Eldridge and Kevin Cross. I think they could have actually kept going. But I imagine I probably could have too, but I got done with my painting, so I was just like, I gotta wrap it up at some point. Get some sleep so I can get up and start painting again, you know? I've kind of switched my schedule to day schedules, so it's like some of these like late night chat hangout things are sort of tough because it's like it's been throwing me off a little bit. Let me see if I can push this a little bit over. I'm actually kind of working. I don't know if you guys can see, but this is like Medusa. And then I got the guy down there kind of ducking down behind the shield with the sword out. And I was kind of working this direction, getting down to her snake body that's sort of writhing in the background here. So I don't want to be working too much off screen, but yeah, I'd like to thank everybody that came. That was like that whole show was just because Neil McAhone and also Lisa Eldridge. We're in the Artcasters Facebook group, and they just started talking about how much they wanted to do a chat, and I just thought, I don't know, I saw them talking, and I just thought, well, it'd probably just be easy for me to set it up since I already knew how to do them, you know. Sometimes it's hard to
get one going when you don't know. You know, when you haven't done a Google Hangout yet, you know.
I remember when I first did mine, I was like all confused. I had to have Peter Palmiotti show me all the just where the heck the buttons are and stuff. But it was a lot of fun. So let's see who all was in there.
Neil McCahone, Lisa Eldridge,
what's that guy's name? Odd. I spaced it. I'm spacing everybody. Johannes Vick is in there. Johannes. I don't know why I still say that. I know how to say it. Sometimes I still call him Johannes, but it's Johannes Vick, who I'm trying to kind of help out a little bit. Sell some Star Wars art, you know. So, but anyway, yeah, I'm trying to help him kind of sell some Star Wars art
and get some Christmas money. And he's got two really awesome, fantastic pieces up. I shared them on Facebook. Imagine I'll probably try to put the links in this video too, or maybe I'll even just edit them in really quick so you guys can see. But, man, he's got them for, like, 99 cents at this point.
Imagine they'll go for that, but, what a steal, though.
So, everybody should, anybody that's just looking for that kind of stuff, I mean, he's got, like, a really cool ink style.
You should definitely check that out.
And with my own sales, things have been going really well. I sold the Centaur piece last night. He went for a little over 200, which I was pretty happy with that. I got the Hercules piece up,
which is finished.
And I finally got a good scan of it up on the site. If you want to check that out, go take a look. I might just repost it in like the blog post that goes along with this video so everybody can see it, because I kind of forgot to put it up on Facebook and stuff. But it's still for auction, but there is a bid, so it's going to get sold. I think it's at $99, which is where I've been starting them. Which, I don't know, I've been thinking about it. It's like, well, I don't know. I don't know if I should go into all that. I've just been thinking about kind of like where I should be starting these things, if I should really just start them at the price I absolutely have to get, or if I should just kind of keep starting them at 99 and just
hope they all go up a little.
I'm not sure, to tell you the truth. This stuff is a little different than like my more fan art pieces or my drawings and stuff that I could get done like a lot faster. It's like they've kind of they take more time, and
I feel like they're just more involved. They're almost like a nicer finished product, in my opinion. And they just have to kind of bring a little more, so. But they've been bringing enough, so that's a good thing.
I'm definitely not complaining.
I appreciate everybody who's coming and bought stuff lately, who bought the Minotaur print. I think I sold about 8 of those so far, which is just awesome. I didn't think, you know, the prints would start selling as soon as they have now, so that's just like really great. And
yeah, I don't know, things are going
better for sure. I just hope everything keeps going better. And I'm enjoying it. I definitely am enjoying painting this stuff. I'm starting to kind of like realize, it's like, am I actually going to be able to paint like this kind of stuff? And that's my job. I mean, that's kind of cool when I think about it. Because I think it's like stuff I really have a passion for, you know.
Lately, since I've been doing these paintings, this mythology stuff and the Conan paintings, I've been kind of like
catching up on a little bit of reading. I don't have much time to read.
Actually doing a little of some audiobooks, which I do have time to listen to audiobooks. But just, you know, it's like listening to some of the myths and kind of brushing up on my own knowledge and stuff. And boy, I love that stuff, you know. It's just fun. I do, for some reason. It really, it's almost like, you know, how the fan art kind of thing struck that, nostalgia chord a little bit with me. And I think that's one of the reasons I liked it. It was like, you know, when I'd get to do Snake Plissken or something, you know, or some movie that I had seen, like Raiders of the Lost Ark. I really liked, those were my favorites, you know. When people were asking me to do like superhero stuff, I wasn't much into it. But, you know, it's like that stuff. I think I liked it because it's like I have that kind of memory of it when I was a kid. I used to love, you know, those movies, so it's fun to paint them. But this was like, you know, something else I loved. And yeah, I don't know, I didn't realize like how much I kind of just wrote it off, like, no, that's not what I do now, you know. And every now and then I'd get, you know, I'd want to do some and put something out, but in general I kind of really kind of suppressed it, I think. And I don't know, I'm enjoying it. Well, let's see, who else was in the art cast? Anyway, the guy Odd, and I can't remember what his name is, but he does the comic The Bud. Johannes Vick was in there, which those two have an interesting dynamic for some reason. I don't know why, but they seem to be at each other most of the night, which was pretty funny. Peter Palmiotti, of course, the mainstay. Can't have an art cast without having Peter Palmiotti show up, or at least give it his blessing or something, you know. Let's see, who else was in there? Neil McAhone, which is, he's a really nice guy. New guy I've met through Facebook and stuff, I guess. He did a really cool Cthulhu drawing that was really neat. Or painting, actually. I don't know if he sells those or not. He was talking about kind of commissions or painting for people. I don't know if they were gifts or if they're actual sales, but that'd be a cool thing to get if you could find where he's selling them. Who else was in there then? Kevin Cross. He stayed forever. He stayed right till the bitter end. Which is funny, like, we do, like, kind of Skype groups and stuff, so I've been in other hangouts with him, and I noticed that he's usually in there as long as I am, and I'm usually one of the last ones to leave most of those things, so. But that was really cool. And who else? Scott Circland. The awesome Scott Circland, who I just watched his Fan Art Friday video, where he did a really cool, what is it? I mean, it's like the Bigfoot guy from Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, you know, like the stop motion ones, Heat Miser and Freeze Meister, I don't know, Ice Meister, I'm not sure what the other guy's name is. Everybody knows those characters, though. And it's a really, really good stuff. And I don't know, I wonder if he sells those things, because I would think that, like, he knocked out three in the space of an hour. And God, if you only got, like, say, $20 on eBay for each one, you know, it's like $60 right there, you know. But I don't know if he sells those or not, but boy, he's so fast, you'd think he could just do sketch cards all the time, but maybe he doesn't want to do that. Not everybody wants to do that. I gotta remember that. But he was in the group, and when we kind of birdwalked everywhere in the chat, but he started out talking about his latest convention experience, and in, I don't know if it's his last video or the video before. his site's called Circworks. If you want to go listen to his stuff, he was making this huge booth type thing, which I don't think he even had a booth. He just had a table, I think. And then he kind of made this like 12-foot tall backdrop that he had prints and all this stuff, and he made his table look like a conveyor belt, and it's just like cool as hell. And I wanted to ask him more about just all of the, you know, because I guess he didn't have that great of a convention. It sounded like he had an okay one, and it was subconvention down in Arizona, I think. But I wanted to ask him more about all that stuff and how things went. But because it's like, man, with that setup, I never got around to it in the show, but it's like with that table setup, you just think that would have to be like, you know, would have to slow people down, you know, when they're cruising by. Just the sight of, like, you know, you got all these artists lined up with all their junk and their little tables and stuff, and then it's like big old workshop type situation. It's just, I don't know. But that's a really cool video, and it's got my mind kind of rolling for, I'm going to do the Denver Comic Con this year again, and just making me think, like, what can I come up with that would be neat like that, you know? Unusual, not just, you know, the same old stuff that everybody else does, so it's pretty neat. He's got some good ideas. The guy's pretty creative, I gotta admit. But this year, I mean, I'm planning on being there with Mike Fleming, and we're gonna hopefully have a board game to sell, so. But there's also, like, I don't know. There's so many projects going. Like, this is actually gonna be the third monster, which, the way we planned it the first time, this would have actually rounded out all the monsters in the game. And the Minotaur was going to be the cover, which I think that's still probably going to be the way it works. And the Centaur was like the fourth monster. I'm talking about the board game now that me and him are doing. And but now we've added like a Skeleton Warrior type guy, so I got one more monster to paint in this sort of series. And then I really want to get back to doing some of the Conan stories like I was planning on, which I can't wait to just do a bunch of those. Those are some of my favorite books and stuff. And I was kind of thinking like a Kickstarter for that, but I don't know, if things keep selling and I might just wait, and then, like, you know, when we get to the point where the board game's done, which should be semi soon, that'd be like, you know, the Kickstarter. Because I was really worried just about the money, and I'm still worried, but I'm a little less worried, I guess, so. But yeah, I don't know, it's just like, once I get these monster paintings done, it's sort of like, I wanted to do portraits of, there's like four more characters that are basically the characters in the game, and one of them is like that Hercules character, that painting, that's sort of what that's for. And I wanted to do like a couple more, you know, we're kind of debating whether it's three or four characters. I'm sort of leaning towards three. Mike's leaning towards four. But if it's, I don't know that needs to be just done before, because they're kind of like just sort of secondary art. Doesn't really have anything to do with the game idea and stuff. So I don't know if I'll be jumping right on those immediately. I just kind of hold those back a little bit. But, I don't know. Everything's going real well, though. Christmas is almost here. My wife's birthday's almost here. Birthday's on 22nd. My mom's birthday's on. Is it the 20? Hers is the one I forget. It's either 21 or 23. And yeah, just so many. Everybody's got their birthday in December except for me. I'm July. But yeah, Tristan, you know, his was the 15th, and I don't know. So I don't know, is that everything? Maybe I should just go ahead and wrap it up so I can kind of concentrate more, because I'm sitting here noodling around on her hand, which I'm pretty much like wanting to just, you know, tear into this whole thing and get try to figure out where this tail's going right now. But, I don't know, I think that's something that needs a little bit more thought than me just sitting here talking. So, anyway, I think I am going to wrap it up, and let's see, what, I don't know, everybody was kind of saying we should do the Yardcast every week again. I don't know if that's going to happen. Maybe. I don't think next week, probably, it'll happen, because that's like Christmas, and just, you know, I just don't think anybody's going to be around Christmas, you know. In my experience on the net, it's not a good time to have auctions ending and stuff, you know. People just aren't paying attention to what's going on, so. But anybody out there selling, too, it's like, you know, like the whole Christmas rush and all that kind of stuff, it really actually goes a month into month past Christmas, because, you know, people get money on Christmas, you know, and they feel like buying this thing they've wanted all year, you know, that they didn't, you know, get as a present. And so, like, you know, they got their gift cards, and they got their cash in their pocket, and I don't know. Everybody's been kind of like, you know, I've felt, you know, like it's been kind of a drag to just, because my store went down and everything, right as all this stuff happened, and I know I've missed so many sales because of it, but, you know, it's just what's got to happen, right, you know, or at least I feel that way. I don't know, just talking to the other guys selling out there, you know, it's like, keep selling, keep listing, you know, for a month or two after Christmas, because your sales are still going to be rocking just because of that fact, you know. There's different times when it gets better. I mean, right before Christmas, obviously, because everybody buys stuff, but it's like, I don't know that there's that many, like, dead times, you know. I've heard, like, the summer is dead, but I don't know. Never really seen that either. So anyway, I think the thing is like, just, you know, when you're not posting, when you're not trying to sell stuff, that's when you don't sell stuff, you know. That's like the guaranteed way not to do it. But anyway, take care, everybody, and I'll see you Monday, probably.